and the tale of Sweeney Todd. His skin was pale, his eye was odd. He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again.
He trod a path that few have trod, did Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
He kept a shop in London town, of fancy clients and good renown. And what if none of their souls were saved? They went to their maker impeccably shaved. By Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. Sweeney
a bow and a fancy chair.
A mug of salt and a leather strop, an apron, a towel, a pail and a mop.
For need this he deserves a nod, the Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. Inconspicuous Sweeney was, quick and quiet and clean he was. Back of his smile, under his word, Sweeney heard music that nobody heard. Sweeney!
Sweeney was smooth, Sweeney was subtle, Sweeney would blink and laugh with skull. Sweeney was smooth, Sweeney was subtle, Sweeney would rock and laugh with skull. Sweeney was smooth, Sweeney was subtle, Sweeney would rock and laugh with skull. Sweeney was smooth, Sweeney was subtle, Sweeney would rock and laugh with skull.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
He served a dark and avengeful god. What happened then? Well, that's the play. And who wouldn't want us to give it away? Not Sweeney.
Not Sweeney Todd.
The demon power of Fleet Street.
Gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again.
He trod a path that few have trod, to Sweeney Todd,
the demon barber of Fleet Street.
He kept a shop in London town, of fancy clients and good renown.
And what if none of their souls were saved? They went to the maker of impeccably shaved.
By Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
Swing your razor wide, Sweeney, hold it to the skies. Freely flows the blood of those who
share. The more he bleeds, the more he lives. He never forgets and he never forgives. Perhaps today you gave a nod to Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. Sweeney wishes the world away. Sweeney's weeping for yesterday, hugging the blade, waiting the years, hearing the music that nobody hears. Sweeney rests in the water hall. Sweeney lives in the office. Nothing can help, nothing can hide you. Isn't that Sweeney there beside you? Nothing can help, nothing can hide you. Isn't that Sweeney there beside you? Sweeney, wishes for the world away. Sweeney, wishing for Sweeney, wishing for yesterday. Sweeney, 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 Sweeney.
Sweeney Todd.
A tender tale of Sweeney Todd.
He served a dark and a hungry god.
He served a dark and a hungry god.
To seek revenge may lead to hell.
But everyone does it if seldom as well.
A Sweeney Todd. The Dean and Barbara Fleet Street.
I beg your indulgence, boy. My mind is far from easy. For on these once familiar streets, I feel the chill of ghostly shadows everywhere. Forgive me.
There's nothing to forgive.
Farewell.
Mr. Todd, before we part...
What is it?
I've honored my promise never to question you. Whatever brought you to that sorry shipwreck is your affair. And yet, over the many months of our journey home, I've come to think of you as a friend. And if trouble lies ahead of you in London, if you need help or money...
No! There's a hole in the world like a great black pit in the vermin of the world inhabit it, and its morals aren't worth what a pig could spit, and that goes by the name of London. At the top of the hole sit a privileged few, making mock of the vermin in the lower zoo, turning beauty into filth and greed. I too have sailed the world and seen its wonders, for the cruelty of men is as wondrous as Peru, but there's no place like London. There was a barber and his wife, and she was beautiful. A foolish barber and his wife, she was his reason and his life, and she was beautiful, and she was virtuous, and he was naive. There was another man who saw that she was beautiful, a pious vulture of the law, who with a gesture of his claw removed the barber from his plate. Then there was nothing but to wait, and she would fall, so soft, so young, so lost, and oh, so beautiful.
And the lady, sir, did she succumb?
Oh, that was many years ago. I doubt if anyone would know. Now leave me, Anthony, I beg of you. For there is somewhere I must go, something I must find out. Now and alone. I had him! There beneath my hands.
Now, dear, don't fret.
I had him, so he's there, and he'll never come again.
Easy now, hush, love, hush. I'll keep telling you.
When?
What's your rush?
Why did I wait? You told me to wait. Now he'll never come again. There's a hole in the world like a great black pit, and its maws aren't worth what a pig could spit, and the vermin of the world inhabit it. Not for long. They all deserve to die. Tell you why, Mrs. Lovett, tell you why.
because in all the whole human race, Mrs. Lovett, there are two kinds of men and only two. It's the one staying put in its proper place, and the one with its foot in the other one's face. Look at me, Mrs. Lovett, look at you. No, we all deserve to die. Even you, Mrs. Lovett, even I. Because the lives of the wicked should be made brief for the rest of us. Death will be our relief. We all deserve to die. A shave. Come and visit your good friend Sweeney. You, sir, too, sir, welcome to the grave. I will have vengeance. I will have salvation. You, sir, too, sir, no one's in the chair. Come on, come on! Sweeney's waiting. I want you bleeders. You, sir, anybody, gentlemen, now don't be shy. Not one man, no, nor 10 men, nor 100 can assuage me. I will have you. And I will get him back. Even as he gloats, in the meantime, I'll practice on less honorable throats. And my Lucy lies in ashes, and I'll never see my girl again. But the work waits. I'm alive at last, and I'm full of joy.
And his life, and she was beautiful, and she was virtuous, and he was naive.
Had a cake maker man. No! Bake me a pie to delight my eye, and I will sigh if the crust be high. Mr. Todd, you harmed her too, haven't you? You know you shouldn't. You shouldn't harm nobody.
Get out!
Go on. On the floor. There's worse things than that down there. That's my boy.
Isn't that a room up there over the shop? If times are so hard, why don't you rent it out? Should bring in something.
Up there? Oh, no one to go near it. People think it's haunted. You see, years ago, something happened up there. Something not very nice. There was a barber and his wife, and he was beautiful. A proper artist with a knife, but they transported him for life, and he was beautiful. Barker, his name was Benjamin Barker.
Transported, you say? What was his crime?
Foolishness. had this wife, you see. Pretty little thing, silly little nit, had a chance for the world on a string. Poor thing, poor thing. There were these two, you see. Wanted a lad mad, one among the judge, and then one is beadle. Every day they'd nudge and they'd wheedle. Still she wouldn't budge from her needle. Too bad, pure thing. It's not much of a chair, but it'll do to get your fancy new one. It was me poor Albert's chair, it was. Sat in it all day long after his leg gave out from the dropsy. Kind of bare, isn't it? I never did like a bare room. Oh, well, we'll find some nice little knick-knacks.
Why doesn't the beadle come before the week is out? That is what he said.
And who says the week is out yet? It's only Tuesday.
Ah.
Easy now, hush, love, hush. Don't distress yourself, what's your rush? Keep your thoughts nice and lush. Wait. Hush, love, hush, think it through. Once it bubbles, then what's to do? Watch it close, let it brew. Wait. I've been thinking flowers, maybe daisies, to brighten up the room. Don't you think some flowers, pretty daisies, might relieve the gloom? I'll wait, love, wait.
Nice to see you, dearie. How have you been keeping? Call me Bones is weary. Toby, one for the gentleman here. The bird is cheeping, hopes to keep it cheery. Toby, throw the old woman out.
God, that's good.
What's your pleasure, dearie? No, we don't cut slices. Call me eyes as blurry. Toby, none for the gentleman. I could up me prices. I'm a little leery. Business couldn't be better though.
God, that's good.
Knock on wood.
Oh my God! Oh no. Don't I know you, she said. You knew she lived. From the moment I walked into your shop, you knew my Lucy lived.
I was only thinking of you.
Lucy.
You're Lucy, a crazy hag, picking bones and rotten spuds out of the ash cans. Would you want to know that that was all that was left of her?
You lied to me.
No, no, not lied at all. No one ever lied that she took the poison. She did never said that she died. Poor thing, she lived when it left a week in the head. All she did for months was just lie there in bed. Should have been in hospital, wound up in bed. Poor thing, better you should think she was dead. Yes, I lied, cause I don't love you. I'd be twice the wife she was.
You're a bloody wonder, eminently practical and yet appropriate as always. As you said repeatedly, there's little point in dwelling on the past.
Do you
so
mean
come
it?
Here,
I
my love.
Did. I swear I thought was
not a thing to fear, my love. God's dead. He's dead.
Married.
The history of the world, my pet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, oh, Mr. Todd, leave it to me.
Is learn forgiveness and try to forget.
Well, see, Mr. Todd, be comfy, cozy, you and me, Mr. Todd, but there's no one nosy.
And life is for the alive, my dear. So let's keep living it, just keep living it, really living it.
That's him over there.
Yes, dear. He's always here Thursdays.
Haircutter, barber, and tooth puller to His Royal Majesty the King of Naples.
Oh, Italian, all the rages.
Not for long.
Oh, Mr. T, you really think you can do it?
By tomorrow, they'll all be flocking after me like sheep to be shorn.
Oh, no, it's the Beadle Bamford.
So much the better.
But what if he recognizes you? Haven't we better?
I will do what I have set out to do, woman.
Sorry, dear, I'm sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Do you wake every morning in shame and despair to discover your pillow is covered with air? Why not to be there? Well, ladies and gentlemen, from now on you can wake in at ease. You never again need to worry nor care. I will show you a miracle marvelous rare. Gentlemen, you are about to see something that rose from the dead. On the top of me head. Was Pirelli's Miracle Elixir. That's what did the trick, sir. True, sir, true. Was it quick, sir? Did it in a tick, sir? Just like an elixir ought to do. How about a bottle, mister? Only cost a penny, guaranteed.
Penny buys a bottle, I don't know.
Penny for a bottle,
oh,
is
let's
it?
Go.
Sample Mrs. Lovett's meat pies, savory and sweet pies, as you'll see. You who eat pies, Mrs. Lovett's meat pies, conjure up the treat pies used to be.
Over here, boy, how about some milk?
Let me have another
right away.
Could we have some service waiter here, boy? Well, that's
from it, ladies and gentlemen.
Toby?
Coming? Excuse me.
Hail there.
Right, Mom.
Quick.
That's good.
Yes. Yes. We know. Okay.
Razor, razor. Cut. Cut. Don't. Atom. And prick 'em. Mark 'em with B. Put 'em in the oven for baby and me. You'll pardon me, gentlemen, but you may not enter here. Oh no. Me, miss, don't let anyone enter here. For you see, sirs, there's much work to be done. So much work! Three times. That's the secret. Three times through the grinder. For them to be tender and juicy. Three times through. Smoothly. Smoothly.
Green finch and linnet bird, nightingale, blackbird, teach me how to sing. Whence comes this melody constantly flowing? Is it rejoicing or merely hallowing? Are you discussing or fussing or simply singing to be solved? is singing when you're tall. My cage has many rooms, damask and dark. Nothing there sings, not even my lark. Larks never really know when they're captive. Teach me to be more adaptive. Ah, green finch and linnet bird, nightingale, blackbird, teach me how to sing. If I cannot fly, let me
tonight.
Tis Friday, virtually Sunday. What can we do with time so free?
We fly tonight.
Behind the curtain, quick.
Tonight.
I think I heard a click.
Tonight.
It's a gate, it's a gate.
It's not a gate. There's no gate. You don't have a gate. If you'd only listen, miss. Kiss me.
Tonight.
Kiss me.
You mean tonight.
Kiss me. Kiss me.
I feel afraid.
Be not afraid. Tonight I'll see. You'll marry on Monday, that's what you'll do.
And gladly,
and
sir,
noon.
I knew I'd be with you one day, even not knowing who you were.
Miss Mary,
if
Mary,
you never
Mary,
come,
Mary,
that you can Monday, call the way,
favorite,
you
favorite,
can kill
the
hand. We're in dinner, she'll trip up by a horse, come to see again, and rest about it. Kiss me.
Of course.
Kiss me.
You're sure?
Kiss me.
I shall.
Kiss me.
Here we go our several ways. Farewell, Anthony. I won't soon forget the good ship Bountiful, nor the young man who saved my life.
It would have been a poor Christian indeed who spotted you pitching and tossing on that raft and not sounded the alarm.
There's many a Christian who would have done just that and not lost a wink's sleep for it either.
Arms, arms for a miserable woman on a miserable chair.
Would you like a little kiss, dear? A little jig jig, a little bounce around the bush. Wouldn't you like to push me past me? It looks to me, dear, like you've got plenty there to push.
Arms, arms for a pitiful woman. What's got wandering wits? Hey, don't I know you, mister?
Must you glare at me, woman? Off, I say.
Then how would you like a little kiss, dear? We'll go jig jig a little.
Off, I say! To the devil with you!
Arms, arms for a miserable
arms, arms! How many times have I told you I'll not have trash from the gutter hanging around my establishment?
Not just a penny, dear. Or a pie.
One of them pies that give the stomach crumbs to half the neighborhood.
Oh, come on, dear. Have a heart, dear.
Off, off with you, or you'll get a kick on the rump that'll make your teeth chatter.
Stuck up thing, you and your fancy airs.
Arms, arms for a desperate woman.
City on fire, rats in the streets, and the lunatics yelling in the moon, it's the end of the world.
Yes! Beetle, beetle, no good hiding.
fanciers and a mischief! Mischief! Devil's one! Where are you, Beetle? Beetle!
Rats in the streets and the lunatics yelling and the moon is the end of the world! Yes, city on fire!
The fastest, smoothest shave is the winner.
Now, signorini, signori, we mix it the lathered, but first you gather around. Signorini, signori, you looking a man who've had the glory to shave and a poor Mr. Sweeney. Whoever, I beg your pardon, will probably say it was only gun or not. It was a bit pop! To shave a face. To pull it a doot require de grace and not de brute. For if you slip, you nick the skin, you clipper the chin, you reaper the leap, a beat, and that's a de truth. To shave a face or even a part without a de smart require de heart. It take a de art. I show you a chart. I started a study in my youth. To cut the hair, to trim the beard, to make it a bristle, clean like a whistle. This from the early infancy, the talent give to me, by God.
Sailed the world, beheld its wonders, from the Dardanelles to the mountains of Peru. But there's no place like London. I feel home again. I can hear the city bells ring, whatever I will do. No, there's no place like London. Mr. Todd, sir.
You are young, life has been kind to you. You will learn.
It is here we go our several ways. Farewell, Anthony. I won't soon forget the good ship Bountiful, nor the young man who saved my life.
It would have been a poor Christian indeed who spotted you pitching and tossing on that raft and not sounded the alarm.
There's many a Christian who would have done just that and not lost a wink's sleep for it either.
Arms, arms for a miserable woman on a miserable chilly morning. Thank you, sir. Thank you. How would you like a little kiss, dear? A little jig jig, a little bounce around the bush. Wouldn't you like to push me parsley? It looks to me, dear, like you've got plenty there to push. Arms, arms for a pitiful woman. What's got wandering wits? Hey, don't I know you, mister?
Must you glare at me, woman? Off, I say.
Then how would you like a little kiss, dear? We'll go jig-jig, a little...
Off, I say! To the devil with you!
Hardly prepossessing. And yet the beadle tells me you're the most accomplished of the barbers in the city.
Oh, well, that is gracious of him. And you must excuse the modesty of my establishment. It has been a few days since I have set up shop here, and some necessaries are yet to come. Sit, sir, if you will, sir, sit. And what may I do for you today, sir? A stylish trimming of the hair? Soothing skin massage.
You see, sir, a man infatuate with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and pomace stone, and lend me a more seductive tone, a sprinkling perhaps of French cologne. But first, sir, I think a shave.
The closest I ever gave.
Bum 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 bum. You're in a merry mood today, Mr. Todd.
'Tis your delight, sir, catching fire from one man to the next.
'Tis true, sir, love can still inspire the blood to pound the heart leap higher.
What more can man require
than love, sir?
More than love, sir.
What, sir?
Women.
Ah, yes, women.
Pretty women.
Bum 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 bum.
Now then, my friend. Now to your purpose, patience, enjoy it, revenge can't be taken in.
Make haste, and if we wed, you'll be commanded, sir.
My lord. And who may be said is your intended, sir?
My ward, and pretty as a rosebud.
She is her mother.
What was that?
Nothing, sir, nothing. May we proceed?
Yes.
Pretty women, fascinating, sipping coffee, dancing. Pretty women are a wonder. Pretty women. Sitting in the window, standing on the stairs, something in them cheers the air. Pretty women,
silhouetted,
stay within you,
glancing.
Pretty women,
breathing lightly.
Pretty women,
pretty women,
blowing out
their candles,
or combing out
their hair.
Even when
they leave you and vanish, they somehow would still remain
there
with you.
There,
with
ah, pretty.
pretty women at the mirrors,
in their gardens,
there's a writing,
flower picking,
weather watching,
how they make a man sing. Proof of heaven, as you're living, pretty women, pretty women,
yes,
pretty women, pretty women.
Joanna marries me Sunday, everything's set, we...
You!
Judge Turpin.
There is indeed a higher power to warn me thus in time. Joanna elope with you?
But sir, I beg you.
Lock her up in some obscure retreat, where neither you nor any other vile, corrupting youth shall ever lay eyes on her again. And as for you, barber, it is all too clear what company you keep. Service them well and keep their custom, for you will have none of mine.
Get out.
Mr. Todd.
Out, I say!
Excuse me, my lord. May I request my lord permission, my lord, to speak? Forgive me if I suggest, my lord, you're looking less than your best, my lord. There's powder upon your vest, my lord, and stubble upon your cheek. And ladies, my lord, are weak.
Perhaps I should greet me cordially upon my return. I should give her a small gift.
Ladies in their sensitivities, my lord, have a fragile sensibility. When a girl's emergent, probably it's urgent, you defer to her gentility, my lord. Personal disorder cannot be ignored, given their genteel proclivities. Meaning no offense, it happens they resent it, ladies in their sensitivities, my lord.
Stubble, you say? Perhaps I am a little over hasty with my morning ablutions.
Fret not though, my lord, I know a place, my lord, a barber, my lord, of skill. Thus armed with a shaven face, my lord, some eau de cologne to brace, my lord, and musk to enhance the chase, my lord, he'll dazzle the girl until she bows to your every will.
That may well be so.
Here we are, sir. I bid you good day.
Good day. And where is this miraculous barber?
In Fleet Street, sir.
Perhaps you may be right. Take me to him.